is today, is that we're only just at the very beginning of hardware powerful enough to create this immersive experience. You can argue that virtual worlds should be like very, very, you know, graphically primitive and web-based.
Yeah.
Some people do, and it is an interesting point because you can take some of what we're doing and just do it on a web page. The problem is that we're all human beings, and there's a certain sort of a magical quality that experiences have for us when they exceed certain thresholds of either timing, latency delay, or visual veracity or quality. Audio has been an experience like that. It's an interesting problem. I personally think that Second Life is sort of just barely good enough to be criticized relative to what human beings expect to see in an immersive environment. And so I think that we're going to have to wait the next, you know, PC adoption cycle or so. I mean, laptops today that you buy off the shelf are perfectly capable of running Second Life at a pretty high level of quality. We need to get the frame rates up. We have been doing that, actually, dropping the crash rates when we're using 3D hardware so heavily. Your computers crash more often running Second Life than they will running, say, a browser. All of those things are things that, you know, get fixed technologically as time goes by. But I think that we've probably still got, you know, 2 or 3 years to wait until you think of the Second Life experience as being akin to the experience of using a browser today. And that's where we need to go.